Greetings, Earthlings! Today, we're deconstructing one of the most famous Vini Caliuta recordings of all time. Of course, it's Sting's 7 Days from the pivotal album, 10 Summoner's Tales. If you're anything like me, you used to shed this as a kid, and if you're anything like me, you probably weren't playing it at a super high level. But today, we're breaking down 5 extremely high-level drum covers of this. I'm going to react to them cold. I haven't seen them. We filmed this so that you're getting my real uncut first impressions. Then, even though it's not fair, and music's not a competition, we're going to do it anyway. We're going to choose who played it best. Because we got to stay true to the name of this series, y'all! And don't worry, because as usual, I'm going to put skin in the game by covering this myself. Spoiler alert, all these other guys do it better than I do. Who played it best? Vini Caliuta's drum part on Sting's 7 Days. Here now, stay tuned. So dudes, before we get into the first drum cover, I want to do a little breakdown of what makes this recording so famous and what Vinny's doing to make it so awesome. Let's roll that. All right, original live extra take, but let's go through this a little and see what Vinny does in the original. Let's go. So the things that make this beat are the cleanliness of the rim shot and the hat. 7 days was all she wrote, kind of ultimatum. You hear how he's doing that offset backbeat. 2, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, we'll skip ahead a little bit because the next bit to nail is the chorus. So fill into the chorus. Then this halftime ride cymbal feel on the chorus. Okay, so that's the next thing I'm going to be looking at in these covers. How is that groove? How is the time when they transition from one to the other? How tight is it? I think we need to talk about the second half of verse 2, where Vinny's playing quarter notes with a kick. Okay. So quarter notes with the kick there. How clean is that groove? And then we have the little bridge. Seven days will quickly go. Let's find that. 7 days will quickly go. The fact remains, I love a song. There's a ride cymbal pattern there we want people to catch. And the last bit is the fill into the last chorus. And fill. There you go. So those are the basics for 7 days. Okay, without further ado, we're going to react to the number one top result drum cover on YouTube. And you're seeing me seeing this for the first time. I've never seen this before. Let's go. Sizzle reel. Nailing the articulation so far. 7 days was all she wrote. Kind of ultimatum note she gave to me. Okay, so it's clear this guy is trying to play the drum part verbatim. Let's listen to a little bit more and then let's listen to the chorus. She gave to me. Seems another suitor here to challenge me. Woe is me. Yeah, it's flash symbol. Okay, let's skip ahead to the chorus. We'll be right back. I don't have anything to say about this. This is, number one, he's nailing the groove. Number two, it's verbatim what Vinny played. Let's get into the bridge between the second and third choruses. So that's how you play this. Okay, I'm taking a cue from this. I know you guys are going to shred me in the comments if I don't do this perfectly. Okay, let's skip ahead to the last chorus. I know you guys want to hear the whole thing. We have to move on though. 10 out of 10 on faithfulness to the original. Also 10 out of 10 on subscore. Like, I don't know. What's going to beat this is if we find somebody who's got a more creative take on it. You know, kind of like Keith Carlock would play it or something. Someone who plays it in a more original way. Let's figure this out right now. I'm saying top of the heap is like faithful to the spirit, but also really original. Second in line is like verbatim perfect, like this guy played it. Worst yet is like not even close. He clearly didn't check it out and the groove is garbage. But again, a little data missing because he just copied exactly what Vin played. All right, so strong out of the gate with cover number one. Let's see what happens when we scroll down to YouTube result number. Let's go on to number two, Pablo de Biasi. Let's do it. Let's see what you got, Pablo. Dude's on it. He looks like a guy I know. Okay, you know if somebody does that on the double splash cymbals, they're playing it verbatim. Hard to differentiate this guy from the other guy as they're both playing exactly what Vinny played, but they're both nailing the sound and the groove. When are we gonna get to somebody who sucks? This isn't going to be very interesting if everyone's 10 out of 10. Like, everyone gets a trophy. Onward. His hand looks really nice. Really good Gordy Knutson molar technique. When I thought the field had cleared, it seems another suit appeared to challenge me. This guy looks like he's gonna go do some rocket engineering after he's finished. Okay. Oh, you crafty SOB, you're playing trad grip, aren't you? Just like Vinny. Okay, I'm actually gonna critique. I'm gonna say the first one was slightly better because this guy's deviating a little bit, and in the ways he's deviating, it's not quite as tight as Vinny. It's like a 99 out of 100. I'm sure this guy gigs. I'm sure he's way better than I am, but I gotta critique, so I'm critiquing. Let's go on to the second half of the second verse. Do we think Vinny did those 30 seconds hand to hand, or do we think he did it with a single hand? Okay, I like that choice. Okay, let's skip ahead to the bridge. Stopping it, I don't think that's the right rhythm. Dang, dang, I think it's 4 or 5. I'll have to check. Anyway, still sounding good though. You know what? I think I was wrong. I think it is the right. Yeah, it is. It's clearly right. What am I talking about? Okay, fill into the last chorus. Here we go. Okay. I'm going 9 out of 10, 9 out of 10. Nice, tight feel in the verses. Loose feel in the choruses. Took some liberties, and in the places he took the liberties, there was more of a visible gap between him and Vinny than the other guy. Still sounded really good. Please check out Paolo DiBiase. Okay, two out of the way. Now it's time for a quick message from our sponsor. Today's lesson is brought to you by me, the 80/20 drummer. And if after watching all these drum covers, you feel like, damn, I'd like to make my drumming a little bit tighter, well, I got just the thing for you. It's like 3 to 6 months of studying with me, offer around the price of a single lesson. More information at the end of the lesson, but if you want a completely free gift that's a gateway drug to that course, you can click the link below the player, enter your email address in on the next page, and I'll send you 3 free videos that'll make you playing better in the next 3 weeks than it's gotten in the previous 6 months. Okay, on to drum cover number 3. Okay, next one is Val. 8 years ago, 83K views. Let's do it. Waiting to see if she... There she did. The double splash cymbals.
7 days was all she wrote. Kind of ultimatum, though.
Okay, opening groove, tight, not much to say about it. Again, no one sucked at this so far. Pretty much verbatim Vinny. Let's cut to the first chorus. Okay, very, 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 very nitpicky. 98 out of 100 on the tightness. Not quite as tight as Vinny. What I mean by that is the subdivisions, there's a little bit of push-pull to it. So first one was the best, the second one was the second best. There's still a little bit more push-pull here. We'll see what happens when I play it. Anyway, it's very good, a little more push-pull. Let's skip to the second half of the second chorus.
My rival is Neanderthal.
Quarters on the kick.
It makes me think.
To the snare drum.
IQ is no problem.
And they give that an 85 out of 100. Let's briefly talk about why. The time budged a little bit. Like when Simon Cowell says you're getting a little pitchy, she got a little bit timey there. Okay, let's go on.
And
nice loose feel though. Look at her body choreography. Look at how relaxed she is. She's not wasting energy. She's also choosing her surfaces really well. Yep. Okay, we're about to see the bridge in 2, 1. I think she started that out with it wrong and then corrected it. I need to check the original. Now let's check out her fill into the final chorus. Nice, muscular, well-spaced. Cool. Going 8.5 out of 10 for both of these. Really great interpretation and mostly great groove. Clearly she's a good player who probably gigs a lot. Vinny is a high bar to clear, and she's come pretty close to it, so dig this one. So I figure after reacting to 3 of other people's excellent drum covers, it's time for me to put a little skin in the game and show you what I did for my own cover. Let's roll tape. So, as is tradition in Who Played It Best, no explanations, no excuses. I just put that out there for you guys to eviscerate me if you feel like it. Let's now move on to cover number. That's going to be Nick Melinda. Keeping me waiting here. Here we go. Sizzling.
7 days was all she knew.
Okay, either second best or best I've heard so far, tied with the first guy. I think he's playing along, keeping the original drum track in. He's keeping really tight with Vinny. The sounds, the tuning, the groove, digging it so far. Let's skip to the chorus.
It's plain to see, it's him or me. Monday, I couldn't wait till Tuesday.
Promos.
Wednesday would be fine. Thursday's on my mind.
All right, I'm telling you, this guy is heavy. Just like the Message in a Bottle cover, how can you tell? It's kind of a game recognized game thing. Not that I'm saying I have game. The arm weight he's putting through the sticks, the difference between somebody who's gigged and is only like a practice room hero, you can definitely tell with this dude. Let's listen to more. So good. Second verse.
The fact is over 6 feet ten. Might instill fear another man, but not in me.
Now we're gonna look at the thing where Vinny opens the hat every, which I guess is like every eighth notes. Check it.
The mighty flea. Ask if I am mouse or man. The mirror squeaked away I ran. He'll murder me in time for his tea. Does it bother me at all?
Quarters on the kick.
Is Neanderthal. It makes me think. Perhaps I need a drink. IQ is no problem here.
You notice I'm not skipping through this, is because it's so heavy. Jazz face this whole thing. Chorus two.
I need that beer. Monday, I couldn't wait till Tuesday. If I make up my mind, Wednesday.
Okay, let's go on to the bridge. Ah, that's how he does it. So good. He just left Vinny's original drums in there, like as a total flex. Even got the tambourine there. That's crazy. Fill into the last chorus. And scene. I could watch this all day. I am going 10 out of 10, 10.5 out of 10. I'm giving him more points than are possible because I don't want to revise backward. Okay, to justify this 10.5 out of 10 a little bit, I have more data on how he would play in a real gig situation than I do for Vadrum. I'm sure they'd both be great, but hey, Bayes' theorem. Look it up. Look it up. It'll be great. Give this guy 10.5 out of 10. Okay. And before we watch our fifth and final cover and choose our winner, one more sponsor message. Remember, this lesson is brought to you by me, the 80-20 drummer. Make your drumming better. You want my coaching course. 3 to 6 months of studying with me for around the price of a single lesson. It'll take you from intermediate to advanced, but we only release it to my exclusive mailing list. Exclusive? What's your exclusive mailing list, Nate? Well, it's not that exclusive. All you have to do is enter your email. How do you enter your email? Click below the player. There's a page where you can do that. And I'll send you a free gift, my 3-video mini course, Make Your Drumming Better in 3 weeks. Okay, on to the fifth and final cover. Last but definitely not least, my hero, Ragov. Ooh. Someone changed the key. Come on. Yeah.
7 days was all she knew. What kind of ultimatum, no? She gave to me. She gave to me.
Okay, so he's doing his own thing with this. This is exactly what I hoped. He also changed the key and shortened the phrase, which means he's handy with the old editing software. Let's see what he brings.
When I thought the field had cleared, it seems another suit appeared to challenge me. Who always me? Though I had to make a choice, my options are...
He just was listening to this and thought it sounded cool and then decided to sit down and record it, which is a total flex. Also, love that Ludwig kit, Ragov. Sounds amazing. Let's look at the chorus. Ah, you remember that little bit. Okay, let's see what he brings in verse 2.
The fact is over 6 feet 10. Might instill fear in other men, but not in me. The mighty flee.
Skip to the second half. Out.
The mirror squeaked away I ran. He'll murder me. In time for his
time. And in.
Does it bother me at all?
Chord is on the kick.
Rival is Neanderthal. It makes me feel.
Love that dead high tune kick.
Perhaps I need a drink. IQ is no problem here.
You know he's gonna pull some stuff out here. Come on, Ragov. Way shorter. Okay, let's skip to the bridge. So he's playing it the way I would, which is all on the ride cymbal. Yeah. Little take five action there, little Joe Morello. Here we go. Fill into the final chorus. Feeling he's gonna do something funny on the outro. See what he brings. You knew it. Okay, Raghav. I'm going to give him a 10.5 out of 10 on subscore. And I'm going to give him a 9.5 on faithfulness, which means in this completely arbitrary contest, Nick Melenda is our winner. Guys, in all honesty, it's really weird comparing and ranking people with the drum cover for two reasons. Number one, it's not a binary. Everyone can have their own take on it, and they can be different and valid. And number two, it's a continuum. So everyone, as long as they keep practicing, is continuing to get better. Let's make one thing clear. I'm not saying I compare to any of these guys. Okay, cool. So that's a wrap, guys. Do you agree with my assessments? Enter a constructive comment below. And little disclaimer, by reacting to these videos, I'm not claiming that music's a hierarchy, nor that I'm better than anybody else. Just one drummer reacting to other drummers. That's it. Anyway, hope you guys enjoyed this one. Be back real soon with another lesson of the week. See you. Inhale it. Oh, window speaking.
Save me from those wicked stairs, not in due temptation.
This is what happens when you have espresso for lunch.
Not to eclipse of fall, but unto revelation.
This also means I'm not going to sleep tonight.
Let's get in the headspace.
Let's think about what we're going to do. What are we doing?